UmpHub, the official source.
Casey Moser for umpub.com. This is going to be a best practices for proper technique of taking a steal at third base. One of the most crucial things for steals at third base in a two-man system is proper footwork. Only having two umpires out here with a steal at third base, it is very difficult to get the proper angle to get a good look at that steal at third base. So your footwork is absolutely paramount to get you in the right position to make a call. Now, let's take a look at this. If you did this instinctively without any teaching, as soon as that runner took off to third base, what would you want to do? You would want to get as close to the call as you could so you could get a good look. But let's take a look if we went straight to third base. If I start moving towards third base as this runner's running to second, as that play happens at third base, what I would have then is I would have a player's back in between my line of sight and the fielder's glove. You can't tell when that tag was made or even if that tag was made because you're looking at his back. So what we want to do here is we want to create a perfect angle or as good an angle as we can get in the two-man system to get a good look at this steal at third. Now, in previous years, a lot of the teachings told you to go to imaginary 45-foot line up the third baseline. And let's take a look at that right quick. I would be in the C position. As the runner was behind me, the pitch was in. I'll check over my shoulder to see if the runner's running. I see him running. I would start moving towards that imaginary 45-foot line. Well, as I'm moving to this 45-foot line, I'm not creating a very good angle. I'm creating a better angle than what I would be if I was running down the line, but it's not a great angle, and that's what we're looking for the two-man system. So current teaching today, they're teaching you to move straight forward. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to sacrifice some distance to get a better angle. My proper footwork is going to be I'm in C position, hands on knees set, ready for the play to start. I will check for the runner over my right shoulder to see him start running. As soon as he starts running, I'm going to move straight forward on a parallel line to the line you were already on in your C position. What this will do is it will create the best angle possible in the two-man system to get a look at that. I'm not closing down at all and getting behind the runner. I'm opening up as much as I can and creating this angle, get down here, and by the time I get to my proper position, I can square my shoulders and I will have the best angle possible. The best practice, the proper angle for taking this play at third base. All right, as you can see right there, if you go straight towards the plate from the C position, you will create an outstanding angle to get a look at that play, and you will optimize your ability to get that call correct in the two-man system. All right, now that you've seen it through my eyes, let's take a look at it all put together. He's out! Now then, I got the proper angle, I squared my shoulders to the play, and I got where I could get a good look. If you notice, there at the end of the call, just a little advanced technique to put a little polish into your game. I took a couple of steps forward so I could get closer to the play as I actually made my mechanic. I didn't make the call as I was moving. I made my decision as I was set with my shoulder square to make the proper call, but I made my mechanic as I came forward. It gives better perception to everybody else, including that coach at third base, that you were closer than you actually were when you made the call.